Secretary of the Harp on Wight International Festival. I'm here with my colleagues Anna, Carol, Tony and Melina. And it's appropriate that Michelangelo's restaurant, it's the spiritual home of Harp on Wight, because it was here in 2014 that the idea for the festival was first formulated. And our director, Anna, has a few words of welcome.
Welcome to everyone. So this year would have been our seventh festival since we start. Unfortunately, due to the situation, we will postpone the normal festival to next year. But we don't want to leave you alone. So this year we have organized a virtual festival that we hope will keep you in touch with us. What we miss is really your presence, just to be here all together. We are missing your hugs, we are missing your smiles, but in this way, with a virtual festival, there will be the possibility to keep in touch, and then next year, when the whole festival will be available as normal, so we will recover from all this time. Meanwhile, enjoy this festival, virtual festival, and I want to thank all the musicians that have supported us and has accepted to collaborate for this festival. And I want to thank also all the musicians of the past and all people that took part of the festival, because this is a festival that has been made year by year with the collaboration of everyone. Every single person has given a detail, has given a step, and has helped us to make the festival as it is now. Thank you very much.
Try a harp workshop. Each year we run this in person and it gives everybody a chance to try a harp that never tried the harp before. So this is for people that are brand new to the harp. I'm Fran and I usually run the courses at Harp on Wight. Today we're going to look at how to sit with the harp, how to play the harp and a couple of little tunes to get you started. To start off, you want to come behind the harp. This is based on a lever harp, not a lap or a pedal harp. They're different kinds of harps. So this is based on a lever harp. Come behind the harp and sit on a stool. Sit on the edge of a stool, supporting your weight with your feet flat on the floor. You're going to pull the harp towards your right hand shoulder and hold it with your knees. This means it's near your shoulder and resting, but it's not being held by the shoulder. That protects your back. You're then in perfect position to hug a harp. Okay, so this is the hug the harp position. And we're gonna start off using your second finger, so your index finger, all the way as far as you can reach to the bottom, the lower strings, and you're going to pull that finger all the way up to the top. you get a lovely glissando. You can then try your thumb. So you can use your thumb and push from the top all the way to the bottom. You can then try with the other hand. And then, if you're feeling really brave, you can try and mix it up with both. That's the thing, everybody loves to do. That's proper harp magic, isn't it? Proper harp magic. So, now we've got to look at how to pluck a string. So I always start on the red one in the middle because it's in the middle, so it's nice and comfy, and it's colourful, so it's easy to spot. We're going to keep to our second finger today, so keep to the index finger. The reason we do this is to get the hand in the right position so you don't learn any bad habits nice and early and you can make the most beautiful sound as quickly as possible. So you play on the edge of your finger. Your fingers point down, your thumb points up, but you can rest your thumb nice, nicely there. Your right hand wrist rests on the side of the harp, allowing you to have a little bit of an armpit breathing space there, and your elbow is parallel to the floor, not flying, just parallel. So your nice relaxed shoulders, but your arms are out, and you've got lots of space with your arm. You're then going to squeeze the string. So you're on the string, squeeze it, and you're then going to play. And after you've played, you're going to bring your finger all the way into the palm of your hand and then bounce straight out. So it's a squeeze, play, in, relax. And that's what makes the most beautiful sound. So try and stay in the middle of your strings, because if you play in different places, you don't get a lovely resonance from the middle of your harp. So if you're behind a harp now, give that a go, or you can try the other hand. So this one doesn't rest, the left hand doesn't rest on the harp, it's just floating. So you have to support yourself a little bit more with this hand. And then you can have a nice relax. And that is how to pluck a string. Next, we're going to learn how to play a tune. Now, if you're used to playing a piano or you've played instruments before, the red strings on the harp are C's. The black strings on a harp are F's. So you've got A, B, C, D, E, F, G. It's also growing in popularity to do solfège. So you've got La, Si, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, and then back to La again. So however you like to learn, that's how it is. If you don't know those string names, don't worry, because I'm going to use lots of different ways to teach you these songs later. First though, we have to do something with the levers at the top to be able to play a tune. So we are going to put all of the levers below the black one, so below the fa, below the F. So all of the mi's, e's, we're going to put up. So look at the F and go one down, so one further away from you, and put all of those up. You're then going to look at the red string, the C or the do, and you're going to put the two strings below that up too. So your La and your C, your A and your B. So if you're working from a 34 string harp, you have down, down, up, down, down, up, up from the bottom. If you're just based on a harp and you've got two C's, you can C's or do's or red strings you can look at, you've got down lever on the red string, down lever on the one next up, then you've got up, down, down, up, up, and then you're back to a red one, so you're down. Feel free to pause the video and you can get your harp ready. For those that are a bit more musical, we're now in C major. Once you're ready to start learning, we're going to try something that everybody will know, twinkle, twinkle. So we've got two red strings. I'm going to use my right hand to start with, so you can see what I'm doing. If you're left-handed, feel free to start with your left hand. I'm always comfiest the octave below the middle C, but you can play on that, the middle C. The only thing to remember is right hand plays the top strings, left hand plays the bottom strings. That's just so you can reach really easily. Bit like piano. So we're starting on the red string, and we're going to play two of those. So remember, your squeeze, play, in, relax. two of those. You'll then go to hop above the black string or blue string. Sometimes they're purple as well. And you're going to go to the string above that. So you're on your G or your sol. So you've got C, C, G, G. Once you're happy with that, you're going to move up one more string. So you're on the A or the La. So the one in the middle. So you've got black, clear, clear, and that's the one you're going to play. And you've got another clear and a red. So all that together. You're then going to go back down one, and you're only going to play this one once. So pause the video and have a play with that if you're in a harp showroom. If not, I'll create a little PDF, and that will be available in the link below for you to download and take with you. Now magically, you're at the easy bit. So that bit was the hard bit. You've done. You were there. So now we're just going to play the black and play every string twice until we get to the red, which we play once. So you've got F, F, E, E, D, D, C. Fa, fa, mi, mi, re, re, do. Now you can give all of that a go. Remember to keep your fingers pointing down. That's quite hard. Lots of people start to do this. You really want to keep your fingers down. The reason you do that is it keeps your arm relaxed, and it allows you to play faster, and it makes the most beautiful sound. So there's three really good reasons to do that. If you've managed that, well done. We're now at the middle bit. So you're going to go to the one above the black one, so G or sol again. And you're going to play two of those, then move down to black or purple or blue or F or fa, move down one again, last one, the one above the red. So they're all just by step, that bit, so it goes like this, three. Happens twice, and then you're back to the beginning. So now you can practice the whole of that the whole way through. I'll play it for you so you can try and play along with me. One, two, three, four. Twinkle, we're now going to do another song that hopefully you all know, and it's called Lavender's Blue. If you've seen Cinderella, the Disney version, it's in that brand new one. So you're going to start on your red string again, on your C, just the once. Then you're going to play three G's, sols, or the one above the F, above the black one. So you've got red, nice and easy. Then you're going to jump down from the black or blue, down, back to the red. We've got to play that a little bit faster, so placing, nice and quickly. Okay, so we're going to add that all together. We're now at the hardest bit. So we play another red one, and then we jump all the way up to the middle clear string. So you've got your black one, your clear string, and the one in the middle. So it's your A or your La if you're used to music. And we're going to play that three times. So So just practice that jump. You've got the red, and then the la, the A. Now, thing to watch is you're not curling around to stare at the strings. You're staying nice and straight, and you're moving your whole arm, not just trying to twist your hand up so you end up with this sort of position. Then you go back to the beginning. So let's try it all the way up to there. 3, 4. Brilliant, really well done. We're now going to add the last little bit, which is really easy. You're going to add from the black string down to the red, but nice and slowly this time. So just one by one, just make sure you're squeezing, playing, coming in and relaxing. So we're going to play that all together now. 1, 2, 3. Up with all of that, really well done, and good luck with visiting a harp showroom near you. We'll put a little list below this video of our usual exhibitors from around the UK, so hopefully you'll be able to find somewhere nice and close that's open that you can go and try a harp and start your harp journey. If not, visit the Harp on Wight Festival next year. Hopefully we'll all be in person and you can come meet me in real life and ask me any questions and learn the harp with me. Thank you for watching and I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you're really interested in harp and getting into it, there's some amazing concerts that are going to be live in the evenings for the festival virtually. You can find out all of the information on their Facebook, their Twitter and their website, www.harponwhite.co.uk.
Mars, on Mars.
Thank you.